This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 8-8 in our books on page 449. The target is I can solve inequalities by using multiplying and dividing. Remember, previously we've been solving inequalities by using adding and subtracting. I'm going to show you how to do it with multiplying and dividing. It says here, when you multiply or divide each side of an inequality by a positive number, and we're just talking positive numbers here, the inequality remains true. Now, I say positive numbers because when you use negative numbers, something special happens. But let's take a look at positive numbers. Look at this example. Notice how 5 is less than 8. The left side is less than the right side. Then they multiplied both sides by this 4, and they show you that 20 is less than 32, meaning the left side is still less than the right side. And then on the division side of things over here, I don't know why they disappeared, we have 2 is greater than negative 10. Left side is greater than the right side. I agree with that. 2 is greater than negative 10. Then they divided both sides by 2. And notice we have 1 and we have negative 5. 1 is greater than negative 5. Consistent again. The left side is greater than the right side. Nothing changed there. When would we use this? When we try to solve inequalities like this. It says solve 7 times y is greater than negative 42 and then check your solution. So what will y be? Well, step 1 is write the inequality. Then if you notice, we have that coefficient of 7, and to get rid of the multiplying by 7, we inverse and divide by 7. And when we divide both sides by 7, we end up with y is greater than negative 6. Now, that means any number greater than negative 6 should work in the original inequality. And the original inequality, if you remember, is up here. It's that one that you start with. So here's our check. I'm going to take a number that's greater than negative 6, let's say 10. And I'm going to plug it into the original inequality, which was 7y greater than negative 42. When I do that, notice we have 70 is greater than negative 42, and that is true. So I've just picked out a number that's greater than negative 6, and it works. So I would say I just checked it. We're good to go. How about solving the inequality using multiplying? Here we are. Solve 1/3 times x is less than or equal to 8, then check your solution. Step 1, of course, is write down the inequality. Then we would divide by 1/3 in typical fashion, but in this fashion, we want to do multiplying. And when we multiply both sides, we're going to have to multiply by the reciprocal. Instead of dividing by 1/3, we're going to multiply by its reciprocal. It's 3 over 1, which is 3. So we have 3 times 1/3, that'll give us 1, and then we have 3 times 8, that would be 24. So we have 1x is less than or equal to 24. That means any number less than or equal to 24 will work in the original inequality. There's the original inequality. So we could plug any number less than 24 and it should work out. We're going to save our time and not do that right here, but it does work out. I'm going to give you a shot at it. You can pause the video here. Try these 3 problems. Come on back, see how you did. Excuse me. All right, so solve each inequality. Check your solution. So we have 3a is greater than or equal to 45. What's the first thing we do? Let's write it down. So we have 3a is greater than or equal to 45. And now we want to solve for a, so we will divide away the 3. When we divide by 3, we're left with a on the left and 15 on the right. We have that greater than or equal to in the middle. So a is greater than or equal to 15. So any number greater than or equal to 15 should work out. Let's pick one. I picked 20 and I checked it. So we got 3 times 20. Isn't that greater than or equal to 45? It sure is. It's greater than 45. So that checks out. There's your happy smiley face. How about b here? N divided by 4 is less than or equal to negative 16. Well, step 1, of course, is write the inequality. Then, to solve the division problems, we would multiply by that 4 right there to get it to disappear. So we're going to multiply by 4 on both sides, and then that n is left by itself. And on the right, we would have negative 64, and we have that less than symbol in the middle. So n is less than negative 64. How do we check it? We'll take a number less than 64, and I think I used negative 80. Plug it into the original. So negative 80 divided by 4, is that less than negative 16? Sure is. Negative 20 is less than negative 16. So that worked out. All right, how about 81 is less than or equal to 9p? Well, we have 81 is less than or equal to 9p. Remember to write it down. Then divide both sides by 9 to get p by itself. And p is greater than, I should say it this way. 9 is less than or equal to p. Then let's reverse this because we like to have that p in the front. And when you do that, don't forget you have to switch the inequality. So we have p is greater than or equal to 9. Easiest way to remember that is, notice how the p is being eaten by the mouth open on the inequality. So p is still being eaten on the inequality on that final one that's circled with the green circle. Now let's check it. I'm going to use a number greater than or equal to 9, which is 10. So 10 times 9, that's 90. So 81 is less than or equal to 90. Works out. All right. What happens when each side of an inequality is multiplied or divided by a negative number? Here's where I want you to pay attention. Here's the one thing. It's tough to remember this, but you, after practicing a few times, you'll know. And then, of course, checking your answers is always helpful to see if you're getting the right answers. So take a look at this. If you graph 3 and 5 on a number line, there's 3 and 5. You see it in blue and red. So since 3 is to the left of 5, 3 is less than 5. So we know that anything to the left of a number on the right is less than. So anything to the left is less than anything to the right. Got it? Pretty simple. Watch what happens when you multiply each number by negative 1. When you multiply 3 by negative 1, you get negative 3. You can see that blue line. So you can see what happens. When you multiply 5 by negative 1, you have negative 5. Now, since negative 3 is to the right of negative 5, take a look at what happens. Negative 3 is now greater than negative 5. What this suggests is that when you multiply, and it also works for division, when you multiply or divide by a negative number, you're going to have to flip the inequality symbol. That's only for multiplying and dividing. So take a look here. Here's the property of inequality for negative numbers. When you multiply or divide each side of an inequality by a negative number, the direction of the inequality symbol must be reversed for the inequality to remain true. Now that's something you're going to want to write down in your notes. You can write it down simply as, when you multiply or divide by a negative number, you're going to flip the inequality. And that's as simple as showing this example here. And I like this example because you can see these simple numbers being worked. You got 8 is greater than 5 right here. So you see that the left side is greater than the right side. Now look what happens when you multiply by negative 1. When you multiply by negative 1, now you have negative 8 and negative 5. But look at how the inequality had to change, because negative 8 is now less than negative 5. So the left side is now less than the right side. You have to turn it or else it is not true. Same thing works with division. You can see it over here. When you divide by a negative, you're going to have to flip that inequality around. All right, multiply or divide by a negative number. In this case, we're going to be multiplying. Let's take a look. Solving a divided by negative 2 is greater than or equal to 8. Check your solution. Here we go. Number 1, write the inequality down. Then, to solve this inequality, we'd multiply by negative 2. Multiply both sides by negative 2. A is left by itself on the left. And we have negative 16 on the right. But here's what happened. When you see that negative 2 being multiplied, this is what changes the inequality. This is where you know you're going to have to flip, because what are you going to multiply by? A negative number. So if you have a negative number being multiplied, you're going to have to flip the inequality. You can see it started as a greater than and equal to. Now it's a less than or equal to. All right, how about this one? Solve negative 24 is greater than negative 6n. Then check your solution. Well, we have negative 24 is greater than negative 6n. We're going to divide both sides by negative 6. So if we're going to divide by a negative number here, notice we're already switching the inequality symbol here. I'm trying to point at it. You can see it went from greater than to a less than. And then, once we do that, we will have 4 on the left and n on the right. We have that less than sign because we switched it. Now, we like to write the n first so we then could switch everything around and say n is greater than 4. And, of course, you can check your answers by taking a number that's greater than 4, plug it in, and it does work. All right, how about these? You check these on your own. Pause the video, come on back, see how you do. All right, step 1. solving this first one. Of course, you write down the inequality. Then you're going to multiply by negative 7. Hey, wait a minute. If we're multiplying by negative 7, we've got to flip. Because when you multiply by a negative number, you have to flip the inequality. And then when we simplify it, C is going to be greater than 98. Now, how do you check that? Well, simply take a number that's greater than 98 and plug it in. So when we do that, I'm going to take 700, let's say, because that's greater than 98, and I use it because I know I can easily divide it by 7. That equals negative 100, and is that less than negative 14? It sure is. How about this second one? Negative 5D is greater than or equal to 30. Well, step one, write it down. Step two, divide by negative 5. Hey, when you divide by negative, you have to flip the inequality. So you can see we flipped it. And then we reduce. So we have D is less than or equal to negative 6. So any number less than or equal to negative 6 works. Let's plug in a number. Let's see here. What number should I plug in? I'm going to take negative 10. Plug that in. And notice I have 50 is greater than 30. That does work. Yay. How about negative 3 is less than or equal to W divided by negative 8? I'll write it down. Then I'm going to multiply by negative 8. When I multiply by a negative, I have to flip the inequality symbol. And now we end up with 24 is greater than or equal to W, or when we flip it around, we have W is less than or equal to 24. Same thing. All numbers less than or equal to 24 shall work. So I chose 16 just because I know I have to divide by some kind of 8. And that's easy to do. So 16 divided by negative 8 is negative 2. So we have negative 3 is less than or equal to negative 2. That is correct. All right. Last piece. It says some inequalities involve more than one operation to solve. Work backward as you did in solving two-step equations. All right, a real-world example. We talk about baseball here. Manny was trying to break his school's record by getting 61 hits in one season. Halfway through the season, he already had 34 hits, and that's halfway through the season. Manny averages 2 hits per game. Write and solve an inequality to find how many more games it will take at that rate for Manny to have at least 61 hits. Then it says interpret the solution. Well, first off, the phrase at least really means greater than or equal to. So we need to know that. Then it says let G equal the number of games he needs to play. Then we write an inequality. So here's what we have. We got 34 hits already, plus 2 hits per game, so 2G. We want that to be greater than or equal to 61. If he gets 61, he actually has the record. So then we, of course, solve this here. Subtract 34 from both sides, leaving you with 2G greater than 27, then divide by 2, and G is greater than or equal to 13.5. So, if Manny plays only entire games, he should have 61 hits after 14 more games, because you can't play 13 and a half games. So, Manny should break the record with only half a season left. All right, last one. You try this one on your own. Oops. Already gave the answer down there. It says Joanne has a total of $250. DVDs cost $18.95 each. Write and solve an inequality to find how many DVDs she can buy and still have at least $50. And then interpret the solution. Well, talk about buying DVDs. So let's let D equal the number of DVDs. And then to put this in perspective, you have $250, and every DVD costs $18.95. So every time you buy one, you have to take off $18.95. And you want to get down to $50 or more. So you want to still have $50 or more. So $250 minus $18.95 times D greater than or equal to 50 is going to be our inequality. That's tough to – that's a skill, being able to pull that out of those sentences and put that together. Hopefully you heard me and how I explained that. All right, so next step is I like to change the subtraction to addition. So we have adding negative 1895. That's all I did there. And then to solve, we would subtract 250 from both sides, leaving you with negative 18.95 times D greater than or equal to negative 200. And then we would divide by negative 18.95. leaving you with D on the left. Now notice I'm dividing by a negative, right? Ooh, dividing by a negative. And when you divide by a negative, what do you gotta do? Flip the inequality. Now I didn't show it there, but I'm gonna show it here. I flipped this inequality right here because I knew I was dividing by a negative. This is when you actually show that you're dividing by a negative and flipping it. So in the end, you can buy 10.6 DVDs. You can't buy 10.6 DVDs and still be above $50. You actually have to just buy 10. So that's what it says down here. It says, therefore, she can buy a maximum of 10 DVDs in order to have $50 left. All right. Don't forget, you can rewatch this video anytime or read the examples in the book. And, of course, there's always the personal tutor videos in the book and the online textbook. And this has been a Friday Shoes production.